Hello everyone, welcome back! I'm Gaming Quitter, the most delicious quitter of them all. Let's talk about the new Galahad Regalia remix, which features two new units, Finny and Irene, who I already talked about a few days ago, and man, I love them already so much. Let's start with Irene. She's a close mana caster in the Light Element. Her first skill is called Armed 17 Scramble, and it's her shareable skill with a skill cost of 4 and uses one charge of the Armament Gauge. Irene and Finny both have the Armament Gauge, which fills automatically. Their skills use this gauge, so basically skill haste will be wasted on them, since this means skills are only usable when the Armament Gauge is filled. The first skill deals 9 hits of 181% damage, totaling in 1629% damage. It also inflicts Fleischburn on the enemy, and aiming is possible during the attack animation. When shared, the skill cost isn't too bad actually. Her second skill, Armed 99 Overclock, consumes one charge of the gauge and activates Overclock. During Overclock, Irene's standard attacks will be powered up and damage to flashburned enemies is increased by 15%. This lasts for 15 seconds and does not stack. Irene has the standard Gauge Accelerator co-ability, and her Chain co-ability gives units a one-use shield that nullifies up to 50% of their maximum HP once their HP drops below 40%. This shield does not stack, and honestly, this sounds pretty nice for auto comps. Her first ability gives her the Armament Gauge, which can have two charges and fills automatically. Like I said, abilities that increase skill gauge, fill rate, or even the auto attacks won't affect the speed this is charged with. Also, if you haven't upgraded Irene, or Finny for that matter, the first level of mana and oh my god, super capacitors will fill the gauge slower than the second level. But who doesn't upgrade these units when they bring them to the end fight content, to be honest? So, well, but just so you know. Irene is a poison resist unit, and her third ability automatically consumes the entire gauge when her HP drop below 30% and restores her HP based on the consumed amount of the gauge. This does not activate again for 19 seconds. So I think Irene is going to be a pretty solid unit that might not deal out the greatest amount of damage with her skill at first sight, but depending on how quick the gauge fills, I feel like she could be good for burst damage moments. Also, it seems like the playstyle would be to deal most damage with her standard attacks anyway, so Overclock is a pretty nice ability here. Before we talk about Finny, I just want to point out that a lot of you watching right now aren't subscribed to this channel. So if you like this video and it's helpful, why not subscribe for more Tregalos content? I'll do my best to keep you guys entertained. Now let's take a look at Finny. Finny is a water axe, and this means she has to compete with Karina, since Cygame said no more buffs. In the Sinistar Dominion fights, she will probably be used more in there than Karina. Her first skill, Armed 72 Fast Break, is her first and her shareable skill with a skill cost of 5. As with Irene, her skills can only be used if the Armament Gauge is filled. Fast Break consumes one charge of the gauge and dispels one buff from the enemy. It deals one hit of 2600% damage, which is pretty straightforward as a skill can get. Her second skill though, Astro Burst, consumes the entire gauge and deals damage to the surrounding enemies. If you hit the enemy 6 or more times during this combo, it increases the gauge's fill rate. You can move during the attack, and if you consume 2 charges of the gauge, the attack will be stronger. So if you have 1 charge, the skill deals 2400% damage with 4 hits, while dealing 3600% damage with 8 hits after the change. The increase of the fill rate for the gauge lasts for 30 seconds and does not stack. As an axe, Finny does have the usual defense co-ability. Her chain co-ability is pretty nice, since it increases strength by 6% if the HP of the units on the team is 60% or higher. So this is basically a straight up 6% strength increase if you don't get hit by big attacks, and even then, you're good to go again if you get healed up. Like Irene, she has the mana Super Capacitor ability. Finny is a stun res unit, and her third ability increases her strength and defense by 20% when her gauge has one or more charges. It also increases attack rate by 15%, so not using the skill and just attacking with standard attacks might be a viable option at some points in the fight. I think Finny is a pretty interesting unit, which apparently can deal some nice damage with her skills. I like that both units offers a way to deal more damage by using standard attacks, so they're not completely skill focused. This has been a nice trend recently in Tregalos to not just rely on skills, and I really like that. Also on the banner on Raid Up is Gala's Xena, who is an amazing light healer. If you want to know more about her kit, I recommend watching my video on her that I made back when she was released. The link is in the top right corner and in the description below. And as a small reminder, this is a Gala Tregallia remix banner, which means the other Gala units won't be on this banner. Only Gala Xena will be on Raid Up, and another Gala unit will be on the banner, but not on Raid Up. Overall, I think this is a pretty good banner, but these units aren't limited. As always, if you really, really want them, this might be your best chance to get them for quite a while, but we do have 2.5 anniversary coming up, so keep that in mind before you go and spend all of your precious Wurmite on these cute Robo Girls. There's another small thing I want to mention before I end this video. With Lilith coming out on the same day as these two cuties, and both of them being usable there, it kinda seems like they were tailor-made for this fight. Like I showed briefly, buffing the units will be more difficult in these fights, and those two seem to be built around that fact. They do have buffs, but they don't rely on them too much. So I feel like they will be good in the Lilith fight, but only time will tell, I guess. And yeah, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, remember to leave a like and tell me in the comments below if you're going to summon for them. If you're new to the channel, subscribe for more Tregallia Lost content and other gacha content. Also, join our Discord, there's a lot of awesome people there to talk to, the link is in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!